Rescue pony clinging to life undergoes transformation that stuns owners. A lot of things have changed during the COVID-19 pandemic, but some heroes have put their safety on the line to save animals in need. The folks at Redwings Horse Sanctuary have spent their time in quarantine nurturing and rehabilitating hurt and abandoned horses, giving them transformations that will change their lives forever. Anguished animals don't have the ability to help themselves on their own, so when an emaciated, abandoned pony was in dire need of help, the angels at RHS were there to save the day. Though Redwings Horse Sanctuary, the UK's largest horse sanctuary, closed its doors when the coronavirus lockdown hit, that didn't stop its heroes from continuing to rescue horses in distress. The non-profit mission began with the rescue of a pony named Sheba. She was rescued from a dealer, and her recovery inspired the formation of a sanctuary in 1984 dedicated to saving horses from a life of fear and neglect, the RHS website states. So, when a malnourished, desperately weak, chocolate brown foal was discovered abandoned in a field in March 2020, employees and volunteers at RHS welcomed her to the ranch with open arms. Abandoned near Dis in South Norfolk, the Cobb Cross foal named Matilda was gravely unwell. Unbelievably, she had a body condition score of 0.5 out of 5. An ideal score for a horse of her age is 3 out of 5. Not only that, but Matilda's coat was crawling with lice. As it turned out, she was suffering from drastic worm burden, aka a small intestine infection caused by Ascaris lumbricides, a species of nematode. Matilda probably got these awful parasites by grazing in the field. Though the nasty effects of worm burden are often mistaken for malnutrition, like a pot belly, Matilda happened to be suffering from both. She needed help, and there was no time to spare. She was filthy, surrounded by her own feces, scared, and in pain. Fortunately for her, RHS Senior Field Officer Julie Harding and Welfare Veterinary Surgeon Nicola Berryman were there to rescue her. Without immediate help, it was clear she would not survive, a Redwings Horse Sanctuary spokesperson said of Matilda's condition. RHS even attempted to reach out to Matilda's previous owner, who clearly didn't deserve her, but they never responded. With help from the RSPCA and the police, Julie and Nicola brought Matilda from the barren, muddy field to Redwings Horse Sanctuary's specialist quarantine center, where she'd be rehabilitated and given lots of love. Tests showed Matilda had very low protein levels in her blood and was anemic. We started treating her cautiously with a wormer and steroids to reduce any gut inflammation caused by the worm burden, Nicola explained. And then, with a careful feeding plan, we were able to help her safely put on weight, she continued. Even with her years of experience, Nicola was dumbfounded by how some people treat their animals. Matilda is sadly a classic example of a pony we often see in our welfare work. The way she turned the corner quite quickly shows that if her owner had just given her the basic care she needed, such as worming, feeding, and feet trimming, then she would never have gotten into the suffering state that she was in, she said, heartbroken. After getting Matilda to gain a bit of weight, they transferred her to Redwings South Norfolk headquarters, which contained their non-profit horse hospital. The vet team kept a close eye on her, watching her slowly become the beautiful, strapping pony she was meant to be. But the folks at RHS felt Matilda needed a companion to keep her motivated and at ease. They kept a more mature pony, Mildred, by her side, who's known as the headquarters resident, Foster Mama. Mildred took the frightened Matilda under her wing and allowed her to socialize one-on-one before she was finally integrated into a herd of ponies her own age. Matilda's recovery included many hurdles, as the process required both physical and emotional repair. The Matilda who went into the lockdown is almost unrecognizable from the one that's now leaving it. As well as looking very different, she's really coming into her own character, Nicola Berryman said. When they found Matilda, she was practically a shell. When she first arrived, she was very sad, showed no personality, and didn't want to interact with us at all. Now she's starting to display quite a curious, cheeky side, which is great to see, Nicola continued. Though it's awful to think this may be the first time Matilda has ever felt happy and healthy, it's a blessing someone spotted her in that field. Now she has some real equine friends, as Redwings has taken in more than 50 horses, ponies, and donkeys since the beginning of the quarantine. Please feel free to share this with your friends.